Hello, everyone, and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube. It is time for another Hurricanes Huddle. Mr. Hurricane drops by with his all-too-famous Vikings franchise. This is episode number 88, I believe. 88 episodes of Vikings franchise and going strong. This is divisional playoffs against the Redskins. Also, I want to direct you to his channel tonight at 5 p.m. Central for Monday Night Madden, his regular live stream with all things Madden. So check that out, Mr. Hurricane. At his channel, I'll leave a link, Monday Night Madden, about 5 p.m. Central tonight. Now time for Hurricanes Huddle and Vikings franchise.
What's going on, guys? It's playoffs time here in the Minnesota Vikings franchise in Season 4, and the Minnesota Vikings clinched a first-round bye, so it's time to simulate the wild-card playoffs. Last time Minnesota made the playoffs, they played in wild-card weekend. Don't have to this time, as the Kansas City Chiefs lose to the Houston Texans, the Washington Redskins beat the Atlanta Falcons in a high-scoring 34-31 game, and their quarterback, Dominique Davis, threw for over 400 yards and 4 touchdowns in that game. The New England Patriots and the New York Jets squared off, and the Jets took home the victory 41-31 behind 4 LeGarrette Blount touchdowns, and Chicago lost to St. Louis in a 22-10 game. So now Minnesota is taking on the Washington Redskins. They did play this team earlier in the season, and it was not a very good game for the Vikings. They lost 41-10. The Washington Redskins dominated that game. Christian Ponder only threw for 156 yards, while Adrian Peterson only ran for 39 yards on 12 carries. So the Redskins look to duplicate that performance, but Minnesota is at home for the playoffs, and we're ready for some playoff football here in the Vikings franchise, the second time they have made it. And so let's get into the action. The Redskins have the ball to open this game, and they're out of the shotgun. Dominique Davis takes a snap, fakes the handoff, throws a quick pass to Austin Colley, who takes a shot from Taylor Mays and is shaken up on the first play from scrimmage. New set of downs, handoff to Saws and Shakerin, and then Keystone Terry, the Vikings' other safety, gives him a hard shot. So Minnesota showing some aggressive defense early in this game. Third and two now. Shakerin will pick up the first down and get into Minnesota territory to the 44-yard line. Now on third down, the Vikings trying to hold the Redskins. Dominique Davis, perfect protection, and he fires it to Brendan Godfrey, who makes the catch and gets a first down, 19 yards. Third and two, trying to keep this drive alive. Pitch out to Roy Helu. He will pick up the first down, running over Keystone Terry and picking up 6 yards now. The Redskins are at the 10-yard line, second down, handoff to Shakerin, and perfect will tackle him after getting 4 yards, so third and six coming up. Redskins trying to put it in the end zone. Davis back to pass, and he goes over the middle to an open Jonathan Sheehan for a touchdown, and the Redskins get the game's first points. It's now 7-0. Vikings have Jamez Logan in motion. Ponder under pressure quickly. He is sacked by Harlos Buchanan, a loss of 6 on the play. They get it to 3rd and 12, and Ponder looking to throw. He drops back, and he's going to throw it right side. Jamez Logan, the cornerback, tried to swat it away, and he missed it, so Logan gets the first down catch. 16 yards, now ground game Adrian, and he takes a shot on his first carry. Not going anywhere there. So 2nd down 11, Logan in motion. Ponder looking to throw, solid coverage, and then a sack for Adam Belsky. Ponder goes down for the second time on this drive. So 3rd and long now. Ponder's just going to go over the middle, and it's swatted away looking for Kyle Rudolph, who was running a deep end and didn't quite get to his break. So the Redskins have the ball now. 3rd down and 5 as Davis finds Godfrey again. I took out Cedric Griffin and put Alphonso Smith in the game, but he still gets a first down. But faced with 3rd down and 5, Eric Norwood applying pressure, but Chris Cooley makes the catch. That'll be good for another conversion as we head to the second quarter. Dominique Davis to throw. He finds Colley, and he's going to be tackled by Morris Claiborne after getting 8 yards and setting up 3rd and short. Handoff, Saws and Shaker, and he runs into Chad Greenway. So the Redskins are going to attempt a long field goal on 4th and short, and the kick is up, and it is going to be short. So Minnesota's defense holds, and they get good field position, trying to run a counter on the weak side with Adrian Peterson, but he goes nowhere. He actually loses 5 yards on the play. 3rd and 15, Ponder under pressure trying to scramble, but he's sacked again by Adam Belsky. So the Redskins, their defense was tough early in the season, and they have not slowed down. The Redskins have 3rd and 8 in their next possession, but a screen pass to Saws and Shakerin was the perfect call, getting a first down. Faced with another 3rd down, this time they need 4 yards, and Davis, he's going to go over the top, and that is Jonathan Sheehan, got behind Taylor Mays. And that was just a bad play call on my part. I forgot that play. The safeties are usually playing really close to the line of scrimmage, and it's hard for them to get to their deep zones. And we go back to offense now. We're down 14 late in the second quarter, looking for our first points and an offensive spark as Ponder is once again sacked. This Redskins unit is applying a lot of pressure and playing very solid coverage, and now their offense has the opportunity to get some more points before halftime with Davis finding Chris Cooley just short of a first down. That'll bring up second down and short. And now Cooley goes in motion, and my hot route got messed up, so nobody was covering Shakerin, and he is the guy that gets thrown the ball and gets a first down. They're in field goal range, the 26-yard line, but look to get more than a field goal on this drive with Davis dropping back. Here comes the pressure and goes the Shakerin on the screen, and then Kevin Williams trying to strip it, but he can't, and it's an 8-yard loss. So Minnesota does back up the Redskins, but Davis on second and long, good protection, and Sheehan makes another solid catch. Gets almost the first down, and it's third down and one now out of the shotgun. Minnesota see if they can hold him to a field goal, but Cooley makes another grab. And that gives the Redskins another first down as Davis has 7 complete passes in a row. First and goal, Davis to throw back of the end zone. Austin Colley, touchdown. And the Redskins, 21 points in the first half. Minnesota, no answer. And they have 42 seconds to do something before halftime, get a little bit of life. Taylor Price back deep to return. He takes it out of the end zone, starts right, and then works his way left, has some room to run. And Price, with his speed, is going to go up to the 50 and turn the corner. And there goes Taylor Price. Finally, a spark for Minnesota, getting some points. Their offense was silent in the first half, but special teams, they get a touchdown, and now Minnesota's back within 14 points at halftime thanks to Taylor Price, one of the Vikings' offseason acquisitions. 21-7 at the half, Minnesota looks to turn this game around in the second, and they're on defense right now against the Washington Redskins with Davis looking to throw on first down. There's Kevin Williams applying the inside pressure and getting the sack. Loss of 8, now handoff, saws in Shakerin, and he's going to go nowhere, tackled after getting 1 yard by Vontez Burfict. Third down and 17, Davis to pass. He's got Hankerson, but he's short of a first down, and Minnesota's defense holds. Can their offense finally get something going? At the 35-yard line, give to Adrian Peterson, and he goes nowhere again. Brian Arakpo this time. This is a tough defense. Third and 8, Ponder needs the throw. He's got good protection outside. Percy Harvin makes the catch, and he will fall over the first down marker. So Minnesota now working in Redskins territory. Second down, Adrian gets the first down. Crossing, getting close to the 40-yard line now. Minnesota looking to get into field goal range at the least. As Ponder's back to throw, he finds Crabtree, only going to be good for a few yards. The Redskins defense very stingy. So now second and 7, counter Adrian Peterson, and still no room to run. So third and 9 coming up now. Minnesota needs some more yards to get into field goal range. And Ponder throws a deep while Logan runs a curl, and that is an incomplete pass, and the Vikings are forced to punt. We're towards the end of the third quarter now. It's still 21-7. Saws and Shakerin gets the handoff and will get the first down. Minnesota's defense unable to hold on third as this drive continues. Play action, and now Davis takes a sack. Eric Norwood, who had arguably the best season out of any Viking defender this year, now third and 11. Vikings trying to hold him, and a pass over the middle to Jonathan Sheehan, making a lot of big catches in this game down the field as Davis, 11 completions in a row. Does Minnesota have an answer for this passing attack as Davis drops back and clean off the edge? Jared Allen is just going to come in and put him down after 6 yards. Third and 16 now, handoff Shakerin, and nowhere for him to run. So now it's fourth down, and it's time for Minnesota to get it going. They're in the fourth quarter, down by 14. Shorts is going to return this inside the 10. His initial blocks are set up, and now he's got some room to run. A spin move, he's up to the 30-yard line, and he will make this a decent return and get the Vikings some okay field position. So can they do anything with it? First and 10 for Christian Ponder. Crabtree got some separation. He's into Washington territory. There's Minnesota's biggest offensive play on the day so far as they go to the ground game again, and Adrian, we're persistent, but he's still not getting any solid yards. 1 yard this time. Second and 9 now. Ponder looking to throw. Good protection. Kyle Rudolph makes the catch over the middle. Minnesota in field goal range, but they want to get a touchdown on this drive. 7.5 minutes to go. Ponder working in the pocket, steps up and fires to Rudolph again. This time he's to the 10-yard line. And Minnesota now within striking range, trying to put put this in the end zone as Ponder avoids a sack and then is taken down by Cobbs. Second and 13 coming up. Ponder got twin tight ends. As Ponder fires it for Jamez Logan, that'll be short of the 5-yard line, just getting it closer to the end zone for third down and 7. Empty backfield shotgun for Christian Ponder as he takes the snap, steps up, throws it to Mark Harrison. I kind of panicked there, threw it a lot quicker than I had to. And the Vikings kick a field goal. It's now an 11-point game. The defense needs to keep getting stops. Davis is going to be sacked by Chad Greenway. That's helping. Second down and 14 coming up now. Under 5 minutes to go in the game. I form handoff. Shakerin. He's met by Ballard and he rips it out. And Greenway is there to fall on it as Minnesota gets a turnover. And now has the opportunity to make this a one-score game. First and 10 from the 18-yard line. Ponder fires to Harrison. That'll be good for a first down. Now they're inside the 10-yard line. First and goal to go out of the shotgun. Ponder handoff to Peterson. He goes nowhere. I'm not giving up on the run. Second and goal. Now split backs out of the shotgun as Ponder fires Harvin in the end zone. That is a touchdown, and Minnesota's now within one score as Harvin gets his 25th NFL receiving touchdown. And I came out with an extra point. I wanted to go for two. In this situation, I just decided, let's take a timeout, and let's try to make this a field goal game. So out of the shotgun, tight shotgun set for Christian Ponder. Nobody open. He's going to step up and take off, and there is Cobbs making a clutch play. Ponder unable to make this a field goal game, and now Minnesota still needs a touchdown, but they have to get a stop on the Redskins first as Davis being chased by Jared Allen, and there he is with two sacks in this game, and that will bring up third down and long. Minnesota just needs one more stop to get their offense back the ball. Redskins showing run, and that's what we're planning on as Shakerin gets the handoff. He's going to pick up a few yards, but nowhere near a first down. So now punt is going to go away to Cecil Shorts. He's back deep. He's got some explosive return ability. He'll take at the Minnesota 30-yard line and start up the right side. Some more good blocking up past midfield. Spin move, and he will be in Washington territory at the 47. A very good return as Minnesota only has to work with half of the field. But Adrian Peterson, still no running game. Minnesota is one-dimensional, and it's not doing anything good for him. Second down and 11. Ponder looking for Logan, and he can't hang on. So third down and long coming up. A big play for the Minnesota offense. Ponder throwing over the middle. There is Jamez Logan this time making the catch, converting for a first down. Now Minnesota's at the 34-yard line, back to the ground game, and still no luck. This time Adrian gets 1 yard. Second and 9. Ponder's going to throw. The blitz is coming, but he gets it out to Kyle Rudolph in time. 7 yards, and now third and 2 coming up. I might have ran the ball here if it was working, but it's not. But the pass rush for Washington is so good. And now Minnesota's playoff hopes are riding on a conversion on fourth down and 2. Christian Ponder has 3 receivers out. Adrian Peterson in the backfield. Ponder drops back to pass. Kyle Rudolph makes the catch. There he is going inside the 10-yard line and tackled at the 9. So Minnesota, goal to go. 30 seconds left in the game. Crabtree in motion, pitch out Adrian Peterson. He's trying to get outside, and there goes Adrian into the end zone, and Minnesota takes the lead. Finally, the running game does something, and Adrian goes in the end zone, the most important play of the game, and Adrian got the yards. But we still got to go for a 2-point conversion. Ponder looking to throw. It's going to be a 3-point game with Adrian Peterson making the catch and going in 24-21. Minnesota pulled off the comeback. 24 unanswered points. Now the Redskins with their backs against the wall. 24 seconds to go. All 3 timeouts. Not a great return for Saws and Shaker, and they'll set up shop at the 22-yard line. Second down and goal. 15 seconds. Dominique Davis screen pass will not happen. 12 seconds to go now. Third down and 10 as Dominique Davis drops back. He's going to throw it deep. 2-on-1 advantage. Minnesota's knocked away by Jamel Fleming. So fourth and 10. Washington's playoff hopes are riding on Dominique Davis. Last play of the ball game. This is their last breath of hope. Heaving it deep, and it's going to fall incomplete. And Minnesota's going to the NFC Championship game. They pull off a 24-point comeback. Derek Mason and the Vikings are victorious. Jared Allen applied pass rush in the second half to help the Vikings defense stop the Redskins and allow them to mount a comeback that was capped off by Adrian Peterson getting his longest play of the day on a 9-yard touchdown. The Redskins played very tough defense, but Minnesota prevailed. Ponder only threw for a 176 and one touchdown. Adrian, 14 carries for 9 yards. That is probably my worst rushing performance in this series, but Adrian had one of the most important plays of the game. Kyle Rudolph had some clutch catches. Jeremiah Cobbs played well for the Washington Redskins, and Jared Allen is the player of the game. And the Minnesota Vikings have advanced. The Baltimore Ravens will go into the AFC Championship game, along with the Indianapolis Colts knocking off the New York Jets. But Minnesota, they'll be taking on the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, who won a low-scoring game against the St. Louis Rams 13-3. And that's where Minnesota's going next week. The Vikings will travel to Raymond James Stadium and take on the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and try to make it to their second Super Bowl in this series. So thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you.